Hello, everyone. We're at Transcatheter Cardiovascular Therapeutics 2019 Annual Scientific Sessions here in San Francisco. And I have the honor and pleasure of having with me Dr. Suzanne Baron. Suzanne, welcome.
Thank you.
Suzanne is an interventional cardiologist at Lahey Clinic. She's also the director of interventional cardiovascular research at Lahey Clinic. And you know, she presented two late-breaking clinical trials or science at the meeting. One we've talked about before, and that was health status in patients with severe aortic valve stenosis, sub-study of the PARTNER 3 trial, which was presented earlier this year, a comparison between transcatheter and surgical aortic valves. And then the second manuscript is a sub-study from the COAPT trial, which looks at cost-effectiveness of a transcatheter mitral therapy, MitraClip, and in comparison with medical therapy for heart failure. So, Suzanne, congratulations.
Thank you.
So, talk to us more about the study on cost effectiveness for MitraClip, because you know the data which were presented actually last year at TCT,
yep.
The COAPT trial was again a practice changing, a paradigm shift. And you know, my take home was we have to be careful with patient selection. And you know, before we start really pitching it as a heart failure therapy to patients, you know, we really have to do a really good job with medical therapy, but I'd like to hear more from you.
Absolutely. Well, I agree with you. I think, you know, the presentation from last year was absolutely practice changing, you know, seeing that TMVR with the MitraClip reduced mortality, reduced heart failure hospitalizations when compared to medical therapy. But that always comes at a cost, right?
Yes.
So, you know, every new technology is costly. And, you know, I think as stewards in the healthcare system, we have to be thoughtful about what sort of value we're bringing to our patients and to society, particularly when the technology is costly, but also when the possible patient population we're going to treat is large and they have a high rate of healthcare utilization. And so what we did is they did a patient level economic analysis alongside the COAPT trial to try to get a sense of what the cost effectiveness was of this device when compared to medical therapy.
So what did you find? I mean, it's a very important question. You know, it's a vexing problem, you know, for heart failure clinics. And, you know, now that we have heart teams, so we work with very closely with advanced heart failure and transplant cardiologists. And it's a conundrum. It's a conundrum clinically as to who to offer and who to escalate medical therapy. But, you know, very important findings. And why don't you talk to us more about them?
Sure. Well, so there's a lot of components of cost that go into doing a cost-effectiveness analysis. So the first thing we got to think about is the index procedure. How much does the MitraClip procedure and that index hospitalization cost? And so we were able to get some billing data from patients who underwent that procedure in the COAPT trial, and then using that as well as some modeling techniques, we estimated the cost of the index hospitalization as being just over $48,000. And then we followed patients for 2 years, and we saw what their follow-up healthcare utilization costs were. And so the MitraClip actually had significantly less costs over 2 years. There was a reduction in cost of just under $12,000 over a two-year period when compared to medical therapy. However, cumulatively, when you put that together with the index procedure costs, two-year costs were still higher by about $35,000. But it's not just about the 2 years. It's got to be over a patient's lifetime. And we
exactly.
know that the MitraClip improves mortality, and, and that's, I mean, that's huge. How do you put a price on that? And so we used the data from the in-trial period to project survival, lifetime costs, lifetime benefits, and to see really where that, you know, falls out. And what we found is that quality-adjusted life expectancy, so not just how long you live, but how you're going to feel when you're living those extra years, was increased with the MitraClip by 0.82 years. But that came at a cost of just over $45,000. So overall, when we put that in the terms of an incremental cost-effectiveness ratio, or an ICER, we came up with an ICER of $55,600 per quality or quality-adjusted life year gained. And so I often have people say, well, that's great. That sounds like a big number. How do I interpret that number?
Sure.
And so, you know, from ACC and AHA recommendations, anything under $150,000 per quality gained is considered to be acceptable from a U.S. Healthcare perspective.
From the cost effectiveness standpoint.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And anything under $50,000 per quality is actually considered to be high economic value. So we're pretty close to high economic value.
That's incredible analysis. So. How does that compare with patients who were just managed medically? Like, and I know there's a mortality benefit.
Yep.
So, you know, maybe talk to us a little bit more about what was the medical therapy in these patients, because, you know, that's also an important point that needs to be discussed.
Absolutely, and I think exactly what you're getting at is that this analysis, while it does show, you know, intermediate to high economic value, really is only applicable to the COAPT population who were treated, you know, who were met the inclusion-exclusion criteria and who were treated with the aggressive medical therapy that they got. And, you know, these were patients who were on, you know, maximum doses of heart failure medication regimens, patients who had gotten CRT, you know, or biventricular pacing. Sure. And so people who were really optimized and despite being optimized still were symptomatic from their heart failure, still had moderately severe to severe secondary mitral regurgitation. Yeah. You know, we followed all the follow-up costs and actually, you know, as was shown in the primary trial, you know, there was certainly an increased number of patients getting LVADs or heart transplants in the medical therapy group. You know, they had to advance to that type of treatment. And as you can imagine, that's particularly costly.
I agree. So how does that, how does the data from last year, the COAPT study and now the cost effectiveness data, you know, alter practice or change practice, have you particularly changed, you know, how you are viewing these patients in clinic or even in the hospital?
Sure. I mean, I think from a clinical perspective, absolutely. If I have a patient who's, you know, symptomatic despite, again, having maximized all of my heart failure regimen, having maximized CRT, everything, then I think that this is really something that's game changing for those patients from a quality of life benefit, from a survival benefit. And, you know, and even though the reality is we do plenty of things, whether or not they're cost effective, you know, LVADs for destination therapy is a perfect example, not a cost effective treatment, but it's the right thing for the individual patient. And so we do it. Now you can feel good about offering this treatment to patients too, and knowing that you're still providing good value to society.
Yeah. Well, Suzanne, great. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for spending time with us.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Yeah. Pleasure.